Hey there, Faren. Love your videos and thank you for everything that you do. Well, thank you very much. My question is, why do people, young, old, intelligent, and in general, still vote conservative Republican? What do they gain by doing so? What would change their mind to stop? Man, if I had the answer for that, honestly, I wouldn't be sitting in this chair right now. I'd be out there making millions as a political consultant. But I do have to tell you that I spend a lot of time attacking Republicans. I call them stupid. I call them ignorant morons, you know, and worse many, many times. But to be completely fair, not every Republican out there is, you know, a brain dead idiot. Okay, that's unfair for me to make those blanket statements, but I do it when I get mad. I'm actually not even sorry about it, and I'm not going to try to stop either. I'm going to keep doing that. But there are intelligent people, obviously, on the right. The reason they continue to vote the way that they vote has a lot to do with simple wishful thinking. You know, polls have been done for decades now, showing that a majority of Americans, I think it's like over 70%, do believe that at some point in their lifetime, they're going to be millionaires. Like 70%+ of the public thinks like, hey, even if I'm like literally making $2 an hour right now, don't worry, at some point I'm going to be a millionaire. And it's that hope that I think a lot of these Republicans have. They're like, well, listen, I'm going to be a millionaire. Probably not this week, but maybe next week. I don't know. I may hit the Powerball. I may go down to Vegas and try my luck. And then suddenly I'm a wealthy elite. And then I don't want to be taxed to hell and back. So I got to support the Republicans. Now, that's just one, you know, possible reason. I think the rest of it is because people do allow their religion to dictate their politics. I mean, that is obvious. You know, we know that the religious right has this, you know, deep stranglehold on the Republican Party that tells these people, like, don't worry about your financial status. Don't worry that your life sucks and Republicans are making it worse. You need to worry about eternity. And therefore, you cannot vote for somebody who doesn't want to ban abortion. You cannot vote for somebody that doesn't want to ban the existence of the LGBTQ community. You have to focus only on the culture wars. Otherwise, God will punish you and damn you to hell. So I think that plays a very, very large role in it as well. But I think the thing, out of all of these things I've mentioned, the one thing that plays the biggest role in all of it is that people don't pay attention. You know, these issues that I talk about every day, and obviously you're listening to this podcast, so you are a political news consumer. You know, the people who ask these questions on our YouTube channel, y'all are political news consumers. Guess what? Most of the country isn't. So while we're talking about things and getting in depth in these issues and you know, uncovering this Republican corruption and talking about the hypocrisy and the horrible things they're doing, you have to keep in mind, and I have to keep in mind because I forget this every day too, majority of the people in this country don't even know this is happening because they don't pay attention. And it's not because they're stupid. It's because nobody wants to be consumed with this stuff. Trust me, when I'm not on the air, I hate talking about politics. I have actually just straight up left family gatherings because people won't stop like asking me political questions. And I'm not trying to be rude to anybody, but it's like, listen, I don't want politics to consume my life. I do it for a living. I don't like to talk shop. And I hate to, like, I don't ever want to be rude about that. But it's also like, folks, look, you don't want to talk about your job when you're not at your job, right? So I fully understand all these people out here who just look at politics and like, I can't even deal with that, because that's how I am when I'm not working. Unfortunately, I'm pretty much always working, but I get it. And it's not only that, I don't want to deal with it. Most people don't even have time for it. You know, they're worried about where their next meal is going to come from. They're worried about the 12-hour shift they're going to have to go pull. And who's going to watch their kids while they're doing it. And who's going to help the kids with their homework. And who's going to pick up the kids from school. And, you know, oh God, the dog's got to go out. And all this crazy crap. Their lives are too crazy to even deal with politics. And you can't fault people for that at all. So there's a lot of reasons why a lot of people still vote for conservatives. But the biggest one, I think, is because they simply don't understand how corrupt that Republican Party has become.